Hey guys, and welcome back to a brand new video. As you might have noticed if you are in the Pixelbit Discord, a secret update just came out. Now, before you say, oh, it's the map and the hero, let me stop you right there. I am not talking about the new hero and the map. I am talking about this message that Smelly posted in the changelogs. Okay guys, don't get too excited, but we are currently testing sandbox mode. A mode where you can place heroes without limitations and can get infinite mana. But it is only enabled for contributors at the moment, since it is not yet complete. However, that does mean that you can join a server that a contributor has created to play it for yourself. Me, Hilo, will be doing some tests before it is released. And after this message, I saw a lot of confusion and a lot of people that actually wanted to see what sandbox mode was all about, because the chance of finding a contributor that wants to do sandbox mode with you is pretty low. So because of that, since I am a contributor, I want to show you around in sandbox mode. So without further ado, let's jump straight into it. As always, when picking a map and a mode, our journey starts off in the lobby. And if I go to servers, create server and change the map, we will see something right away. There is something new called test map. And we can click it and we can see test map still has a casual mode, still has a challenge mode with Lampy. I'm not sure what that is about, but let's check it out later. And of course, sandbox mode. So this is how you get into sandbox mode. I want to stress once again, it is only for contributors. So you guys can probably not find this option. Keep that in mind. Secondly, it is not quite sure if this feature will be released to the public, so please keep that in mind. Of course, you can always join the test map when somebody with contributor clicks public server, but the chances of you finding that is kinda low, unfortunately. And here we are, we arrived at the test map. And the first thing that you will probably see is that the test map actually looks pretty cool, even though it's just a test map. They even did put a little bit of thought behind the design, which is always appreciated, because they totally didn't have to for a test map, but it's still cool that they still put effort into it, which is just always really appreciated. I really like how the map looks, actually. So the first thing that we notice when we go to the map is that we will see that our mana is infinite. We got infinite health on our health bar and the time does not increase. We got a giant field for raids and a small path for little paths. Of course, we also got some awesome green screens and two secret buttons. So the first thing that we can do is basically just place unlimited heroes without the hero limit. For example, if we take card kit, we can place a card kit, another card kit, even more card kits, not more card kits, even more, even more, even more. Damn, that is a lot of card kits. And we can see them all going down this path. And that is because right now the mode is set to classic mode. But when we go over to the buttons, we can actually switch it to raid mode. And from now on, the card kits will spawn in this giant raid area. As you can see, some have already started spawning. And something that I notice right now, which is pretty weird, is that some card kits actually spawn without the skin. That's actually pretty weird, and I have no idea why that's happening. That shouldn't happen. We gotta look into that. But still, as you can see, they switch from the one lane to the raid lane, which is pretty cool to come up with new raid strategies. The second button is quite simple. It changes it from daytime to nighttime. to help you with placing lampies and kind of figuring out how big the range of lampy is. Maybe nighttime looks cool for a thumbnail. It gives a lot to do. It's also super cool that the green screen areas are lit up, so you can still use them even though night mode is activated. Okay, so seeing card kits go from one end of the screen to the other is pretty cool, but we might want to see some enemies, right? Well, luckily, you can spawn in enemies by going to the options, spawn mob, and here you can basically spawn any enemy. For example, let's spawn a king slime, shall we? All you gotta do is just click spawn, and there is our epic king slime boss, and he acts exactly like he would in the normal game. You might have noticed this little friendly button right here, and that is because we can also spawn any enemy as a friendly, just as if they were spawned by Jester. For example, let's spawn the easy boss as a friendly. And there he is, ready to fight on our side. Let's see how he handles the slime. Ouch, that slime didn't stand a chance. And look at the knight going, ready to kill the king slime. Of course, because there are no limitations, there's actually a lot and a lot that you can do that you couldn't do in a normal game. Wanna have an epic dance party with all your Rem Vocas? Well, now you can. Wanna have an epic boss on boss fight? Now you can. Ha! Looks like that one won the battle. Wanna place the entire map full of Rem Vocas? Now you can. Oh my god, this is the dream coming true. I wanna live here and never leave. So amazing. Wanna write down your own name with fences? Well, you can. Or not. The fences aren't placing. Ha! Oh well, just assume that you can in the future once it gets fixed. Yeah. Okay, let's actually see what challenge mode on the test map is. Because it shows lampy and it actually makes me really interesting to see if the boss is actually lampy or not. So, let's actually see if lampy is the boss. I'm actually really excited to see if he is or not. So, on challenge mode, we can actually see that we now got health, the timer goes up, we got waves, we can skip waves, and enemies are spawning. Oh, and we even get to play stuff with the limits. I didn't expect that. I don't think I brought the best team, but let's see if we can make it all the way till the boss. Let's hope it doesn't spawn too much crazy stuff and just keeps on spawning slimes. That would be nice, wouldn't it? So right now I got this setup, like some lemonade kits for money, we got card kit, some Vocas and a Spectre. And as you can see, it actually spawns different enemies than slimes, like golems, spiders, we have seen some goblins. So I'm actually pretty excited to see what enemies will all spawn. It's actually pretty cool so far. So let's see what else we can find on the map. Okay, this wave 25. Something huge is approaching. Let's see what it is. What's it gonna be? I'm so excited. Come on. What's it gonna be? Oh, it's just King Slime. That's a little bit sad. I think we can beat it with this setup. I'm not sure. I'm gonna place one more wizard. And let's see if we can beat King Slime. That's a little bit disappointing. But it's not that bad. Oh, he actually has very little HP. Only 10k. Kill him, card kid. Okay, I didn't do as much damage as I expected. But still, this is all in the bag. Like, easy in the bag. Yeah, there he goes. He's getting melted by King Slime. What I do wonder, though, because we is a mode, do we get money for the test map? Let's see. Do we get money? I'm actually really curious about that. Ah, turns out we don't, but we do got an end screen with a time, which map it was, a return to the lobby and a replay button. So, actually it's not that bad, it's more than I expected. Still, really cool. And in case if you were wondering if you can go to sandbox mode in any map, yes, you can. Any map in the game can have sandbox mode. So, it is possible to spam Vocas and card kits on any map, which is super cute. I can take all my billion Vocas anywhere I want, which is super cool and super cute. Like I said, this feature is for contributors or higher only at the moment, and it is not quite sure if it will be open to the public at some point or even when. But you can actually join a match. So if we go to a public server, create a map, open the test map, put it on sandbox mode and turn it to public, you will see that other people that aren't contributors are able to join and play the map. And as you can see, here we are all on the test map, which is pretty cool. And now we can spam endless enemies just like this guy over here. So let's play some Vocas along the road and let's see if people are gonna join us in spawning some epic stuff like card kits. Yay! Come on, card kits spam! Here come the blood cheese. Will they attack the card kits? Yes, the card kits doesn't even stand a chance. Uh-oh! No, Blutchy! I think we got this. Yeah, we got enough card kits to even stand a chance. That's very nice. Wow. Awesome. So yeah, that was sandbox mode. And I'm gonna say it again because I can't clarify it enough. This is only for contributors and higher at this point. The developers have no idea when it comes out to the public or if it's even gonna come out to the public. So keep that in mind. That said, I wanted to make this video because I saw so many people confused, so many people wanting to know more about sandbox mode. So I tried to put all the information that I have in one easy video so you guys can see what sandbox mode is about, how it works, etc. Anyway guys, if you thought this video was helpful or just want to see more, please hit that like and subscribe button. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye!